Hi, I'm Aaron Wybrow. I am doing a lockdown edition video with Christy Brisbane from All Sorts Sorted. Christy, tell us a bit about yourself, what you do.
Hi, guys, and hi, Aaron. Thanks for having me on. I am the owner and director of All Sorts Sorted. We are a local Hills-based cleaning, housekeeping, and home organisation business. So we take care of all the in-home assistance needs for clients in the Hills area. Yeah.
Awesome. So people might be wondering what a mortgage broker and a housekeeper cleaner are doing together talking about things today. So we were talking before, we thought we'd just touch on three things. One is, let's have a chat about the organization. Let's have a chat about how that relates to mortgage broking. So we got three points. One is we're going to have a look at what you got. Number two is we're going to see what we need to do differently, cull, think, organize, throw out, change to get going. And number three is what do we got left and what can we make beautiful out of what's left and store it in the right way or even buy the right property. So when you come into a house, Christy, we're going down the path of what we got. What's the funkiest thing someone's got, but you've went, oh my God, that's bad, or oh my God, wow, you've got something like that?
Yeah, for sure. Probably the weirdest thing. Well, I mean, it's not really weird, but it was confronting. Someone had stored like their dog's ashes in like a box, like a sealed box. But we just saw this box with a plaque that said, you know, like the dog's name when it died. And I was like, oh my gosh, these are their dog's ashes just like stored in the cupboard somewhere away. So that was definitely the weirdest thing, or yeah, strangest thing I've come across. Probably like the wow thing is people storing like just really expensive clothing or like watches and things just away in the back corner. They're not on display. They're not being used. These like ultra expensive items, ticket items, just like stored away. They don't even use it, like collecting dust. So that's probably like another thing. I'm like, you know, everyone lives differently. So it's interesting to see how, just how different everyone is.
And I suppose with some of that, putting the weird one aside, which it's pets are our best friends, and having them for life and things is important for many different people. But with the stuff that's in the back of the closet that's really expensive and it's really nice to have, and then you might see some newer stuff at the front of the closet that people just keep buying, like it must be amazing when you find this stuff at the back of the closet and you bring it forward for them to now use again, and maybe they're going to be saving a bit of money because they've identified something that they should just adjust how they think about things.
100%, exactly right. You know, most people, when we are going through things, we're sometimes we'll sort them through ourselves and we'll come up with different things that we think, you know, they have double or triple of this, they don't need all of this, or we'll sit with them and actually, you know, it's about actually pushing them to go through things. So most people won't do it on their own accord. They just need someone to help them take that next step. So we'll go through things with them. And often when we're doing that, they'll say, oh my gosh, I forgot I got that. Or, oh, I've been looking for that everywhere, I couldn't find it. And, you know, I went out and bought another one because I couldn't find it. And now I've got like 40 of the same thing because I couldn't find it. So yeah, I mean, it's rewarding seeing people find things that they thought they'd lost, or they thought was stolen, or they thought it they'd left behind somewhere, and then use them in everyday life. And also people creating new uses for old things. So finding stuff that, you know, they put in the back of the corner, in the back of the cupboard, but they kind of forgot it was there. It was mindless that it was there. And then we find it and they're like, oh, you know, I could use that here, or I could actually give that to, you know, blah, blah, blah. They said they needed something like this. So people actually finding new uses for old belongings is another good thing about the what do you have section, I suppose.
And it's so, so interesting to hear you talk there, because a lot of my conversation with a first client is around the same thing. It's like that nice shiny old object that's in the back that they keep buying something new of, it saves them money in their deposit, or the old subscription that they have to a I don't know, pick on Apple, they've got some sort of U-Boot iCloud, massive subscription that comes out all the month and they don't even own an iPhone anymore. Things like that, that they just don't know. Or even you're sitting down and you're trying to get a tidy up and you're going, okay, what's the husband got in a stereotypical way? What's the wife got? We put it all together and we're trying to mix it all together and trying to get the right, who's got what credit card and who's got that and what's on the credit file, what's not. So we can just put it on the table and we can go, okay, do we need that? Do we need that? Do we need that? And then we can bring that old stuff to the front. Maybe we need to reactivate the Netflix account instead of the Foxtel because you got both of them. So yeah. It's really cool when people, and then people go, oh, where should I be saving my money? Should I put it in a funky scheme that the government's got, or should I just put it in a savings account, or should I put it there? I've put it into like a bajillion accounts and I have no idea where things are going, and can I really buy my house? It's really, really cool to hear you talk the same way I talk. And obviously I love parallels. So I love hearing how organization and mortgage broking can work together. So number two, so we're looking at culling what we don't use. So we've got everything out and we're going to use a new fancy dress or suit that you found for your clients. So how do we go down this culling line?
Yeah. So I like talking mostly about the wardrobe because I find that's where people tend to keep things that they don't need. So within the wardrobe, when we come to the culling stage, so we're going to declutter, we're going to get rid of things that they don't use anymore, they don't need anymore, or could be used better in another place. So I have two rules. The first one is the 12-month rule. So if you haven't worn it in 12 months, get rid of it. If you haven't used it in 12 months, get rid of it. If you couldn't even remember it was there, get rid of it because you weren't going to wear it anyway. So something that's been lost for 12 months, you haven't worn it, you don't think you could wear it again, that needs to go because you're not going to wear it again. Why are you storing it? And then the second rule is every time you buy something new, you get rid of something you already own and you're not wearing anymore. So this is a good maintenance task. So, you know, once you do a big cull, then these are the everyday upkeep of that cull. So say I go out and buy a new jumper, I'm going to go home and get rid of a jumper that I'm not wearing much anymore, or someone else could wear instead of me, you know. Then once you're going through the decluttering stage, in terms of actually getting rid of this stuff, you don't want to just throw all of it into landfill. That's really bad for the environment. You want to find either a place to donate your clothes that will use it for, you know, resale, so Salvos, Vinnies, any op shop like that, or a charity that actually distributes the clothing for free. So sometimes there's different charities that do it for, you know, people fleeing domestic violence, et cetera, et cetera. Or you can sell it. So some people have, you know, secondhand clothing stores online, things like that. So you can resell your clothing if it's of value. And then obviously there's the chucking out. So if something is unwearable, then you have to chuck it out. But that's how we go about the culling side of things. So what I'm seeing as a parallel with the mortgage breaking is probably the 12-month rule. Yeah, for sure.
It's a cool, I wrote down the 12-month rule because I might have to use that again at another time. The thing about the culling came to mind was people come to us and they have an old credit card. Yep. It's got like a limit of $40,000. They've not used it for years, but they want to hold on to it. It's mine. I don't want to get rid of it. What if I have a rainy day? What if I do this? And I'm going, well, if you hold on to it, you can only borrow this much money. And if you get rid of it, we can go to this much. And if we go to this month under the right circumstances, you're probably not going to need that credit card ever again.
Yeah.
And the culling is okay. Well, maybe we can keep the credit card. We'll just reduce it from 40 grand to $5,000, and that'll change everything. Or even better would be to take a few videos of mine to convert your credit card from into a debit card, and how you can do that easily. And I think you're right. 12 months. If you haven't used that credit card for 12 months, get rid of it. If you are saving on a savings journey, and you can really link it in. Like if you've got clothes that you can sell, you've got stuff in your house that you can sell, and you're on a savings journey to buy another house or a house to live in, get people like Christy in, because you might actually find that eBay becomes your best friend, and you might have had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 grand of money just sitting there which could add to your deposit. So the culling, love making things minimalistic, less complicated, and move forward. Yeah. So yeah, culling's pretty good. Anything to add to culling there?
I don't think so. I think, yeah, once you actually do a big cull, it's important to keep on top of things. Otherwise, you'll have to do it again.
Yeah, and I think that that other thing, accountability, because people are doing it because you're there, aren't they, Christy? And people do it because I tell them that if they don't, they're at here instead of here. Yeah. So the third thing I wanted to talk about is we've now found they're wearing their nice dress from the back of the cupboard. They've made a little bit more money by selling some stuff off, and now we've got stuff left, and we've got to do something with it. What are we going to do?
So this, not so much in the wardrobe. Well, yes, in the wardrobe, but this is more seen in things like linen cupboards and kitchen pantries, home offices, toy rooms. So once we've actually culled and we know what we have left, it's actually about finding practical ways to store that. So store it so that a child could get to the toys and know where to put them back, so that your mum-in-law who's coming to visit can open the pantry and know where to find this spice and know where to put it back. And so that, you know, if you have a friend who's coming to get some clothes from your wardrobe, that she knows where to find this certain t-shirt and she knows where to put it back. So it's about making a home for things and making the home known to who's using the space. So, you know, practically speaking, in a wardrobe, if you have shelving, the best way to go about that would be to, you know, buy an extra product like a bin or a container that you can then file fold and store things in, you know, matching hangers, things like that in a wardrobe sense. In terms of a kitchen, it's about labeling and containers so that everything has a home and you know exactly where to put it back. Same goes for a toy room, a home office, everything like that. It's just making the home known and making the home in the first place, really. So that's more of the actual organizing side of things and thinking creatively about how you can store something that really works for the person using it. So some people might be really short, they need access to certain things. Some people are really tall, they need access to things at a different level. So things like that, being practical for the client and being, you know, creative with their circumstances.
And I use a word that I love to do is we meet our clients where we are and we come up with creative solutions to meet their needs, where you have a shorter person and putting the right equipment and items that they need to use on a regular basis where they are, or a child. I know shopping centers do children very, very well with the candy down the bottom, or that's what my daughter says, candy. I'm getting a bit American, I suppose. Lots of YouTube going on at the moment. But I think we meet our clients where they are and we get them into the right spot and we make them look as beautiful as they can in the end. And some clients of mine, they get complicated to begin with and we cull it all out and we get it down to the right creative outcome for them. And we internally in my business, I was thinking while you're saying cleaning, I've got a folder system set up so everyone in my company knows where to find the information for a client. All the modeling that we do with people, trying to choose this home to this home to this home because it changes all the time. And then with people that want to do more than one property, we try to make sure that we've got a property portfolio ready to go for this is the first property, this is the next one, this is the next one, what's their account number, when's their repayment due, what's their interest rate at the moment. So when we come to talk about keeping them accountable for the next clean, the next organization, the next child that they're going to throw the dad out of the office because it now has to become the baby room, we can get people like you in and we can get it all done and we can go, okay, well, Mr. Bank, give us a better rate. All right, we need to put dad somewhere so he can work. So instead of the kitchen table, let's use maybe part of the media room or whatever it is. So I think keeping everything organized makes it so much more powerful, not only for your house, but also when you've got it cleaned up and you've got a broker on your side managing your properties, not necessarily talking every day, not necessarily cleaning every day, but when you make a phone call and you go, I want to buy this property, here's the real estate link. It's easy for me to go, tick, 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 tick. All right, there you go. And yeah. It's just probably the same thing when another baby comes along or you need to squish, you need to get like the TARDIS going on with your cleaning stuff. You need to fit everything in this instead of this now.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, that's
so
good.
So it's pretty cool. So we always got to think of what we got. And I reckon, I don't think we should do this alone. This is the thing. One of the things this day and age, everyone's a specialist at something. Like I do loans every day, full time, all the time. Christy does organizing every day, all the day, full time. You people listening would be nurses, doctors, could be teachers, business coaches, could be anyone selling property, all that stuff. Like I would go to people that do the specialist stuff. Just pay for it and you'll change your life.
Yeah, for sure. 100% agree with Aaron.
There you go. Cool.
Yeah, awesome.
All right. So where do people find you, Christy?
Yeah. So we are all over the internet. You can find us basically anywhere. So Instagram, Facebook are two of our biggest ones. We have a website, our name, All Sorts Sorted. It's a little bit of a mouthful when you don't recognize us, but once you get it, you've got it. All Sorts Sorted. And so yeah, check us out on Instagram, send us a DM if you'd like some more info. But yeah, we're in the middle of lockdown at the moment, so we have a little bit of extra time. We're doing a lot of online activity and education, just on decluttering and the power of organization. So if you have been interested in what we've been talking about today, feel free to jump on. They're all free of charge, just trying to help everyone get into the headset of organizing and decluttering during this time. It's a great time to get on top of everything in your home.
Absolutely. And if I use Christy for my office, so when lockdown's over, we'll need to get that sorted, All Sorts Sorted too. But yeah, jump in, make sure you jump on the list to get her in when you find out that you probably want to spend more time with your kids and on your work than sorting out your home.
Exactly right. Thanks so much for having me.
No worries. Thank you.